Hi, this video is going to go over non-parametric tests of significance, and we'll be focusing on the chi-square tests. Non-parametric tests of significance are different from other tests of significance mainly because they have fewer assumptions about the distribution of the data we're working with, and normality is one of the assumptions we're not enforcing with this particular body of tests. And this is useful as we'll be examining proportional differences for nominal or ordinal level data. As with other tests of significance, what we're doing, this is continuing our analysis of group differences. We want to know if we can generalize from our sample to the population about group differences. So we're going to be looking at two types of chi-square tests to do that. The first is the one-way chi-square test, which simply examines the distribution of one variable, and it's going to compare the observed with some expected frequencies. So the chi-square, the question is, how close do the observed frequencies in a particular frequency distribution align to what we would expect if the distribution were random? If the differences are great, then we probably will wind up rejecting the null hypothesis of no difference. So to find the one-way chi-square value, we need to compute the differences between the observed and expected values. We need to square those differences, then divide that by the expected frequencies, take the sum of the quotients, and set up a calculation in tabular form. So here's an example. A researcher was interested in studying the phenomenon known as social distance, the reluctance of people to associate with members of different ethnic and racial groups. She designed an experiment in which students enrolled in a lecture course were asked to choose a discussion group, all meeting at the same time in the same building, based on just the ethnic and racial stereotype associated with the names of the teaching assistant. So you can see the teaching assistant names here, Chang, Schultz, Goldberg, Rodriguez, kind of imply different ethnicities. So based on the enrollments, using a one-way chi-square test, are there differences? And can we generalize from this sample to a broader population? So what we see is, this is our frequencies, 10 enrolled in Chang, 24 in Schultz, 10 enrolled in Goldberg, and 16 in Rodriguez. Since we have 4 groups and 60 students, our expected frequency is going to be 60 divided by 4, or 15. And in this table, we see the observed frequencies set up next to the expected. This column is the difference between those. This is a square of those differences. And this is the square of those differences divided by the expected frequency of 15. And if we add those together, we get a chi-square value of 8.81. And with degrees of freedom of k minus 1, which is the number of categories, minus 1. And we have four groups here. So 4 minus 1 is 3. And that's going to give us 7.815 if we look that up on the chi-square table. So based on that, because 8.81 is greater than 7.8, we reject the null hypothesis of no difference. And what that means is that students did tend to self-select into groups based on their preconceived notions. At least we have evidence that that's the case. And as we look at the frequency distribution, we can see that most preferred the name Schultz, and people avoided the Chang and the Goldberg course more than they avoided the Rodriguez course. And those differences are statistically significant, meaning we can generalize to the broader population from the sample. All right, so next we're going to look at a two-way chi-square test, which is going to build off of two variables in a frequency distribution we call the crosstab. So the null hypothesis again is that the frequencies in the populations do not differ. Meaning that any differences we see in the table are just due to sampling error, perhaps. So to calculate the two-way chi-square, it's similar to the one-way, except now we have a little more complicated way of coming up with the expected frequencies. So we're going to start with our observed values in the table, the cross tab. We're going to find row and column margin totals. We're going to find expected values based on those. And then follow a one-way tabular calculation procedure. We're going to find the critical value with degrees of freedom equal to the number of rows minus one, the number of columns minus one, and then based on those degrees of freedom and our calculated test statistic, we're going to compare to, that should just say the chi-square distribution. There you go. How about that? Correction on the fly here. So our expected frequency calculation is proportional to margin totals. So row margin totals times column margin totals will be divided by the grand total to give us an expected value for each cell in the crosstab. So for the chi-square test for a crosstab, we state the null and alternative hypotheses, find the degrees of freedom, compare the calculated value to the critical value from the table, and then either reject or fail to reject the null hypothesis. And then we're going to state our conclusion in plain language. This works with a 2x2 table. That's how we're going to study this, but the same principles hold for anything larger than a 2x2 table. It just gets a little bit more timely in terms of the hand calculation. But we can do this. We can extend this beyond the 2x2 table. So let's look at an example. This is a 2x2 table of preferences for slasher films, and we're comparing the films Saw and Friday the 13th by gender to see if there are any differences between males and females for preference for the films. And we're going to use the chi-square test to do that. So the expected values to get, we need an expected value for each of these different cells, and that's going to be multiplying the row total by the column total and then dividing by the overall total sample size. So we'll come down here, and you can see we've laid out the observed next to the expected, and we look at the absolute difference, and what we find is there's no difference, just kind of eyeing this, right? Because they're the exact same values, but because we do subtract 0.5 from the difference, we have that value down this column, and then we square that, and then we take the sum of those squares, right, divided by the expected value. So that gives us a chi-square of 0.09. If we look up our critical chi-square value from the chi-square table, with k minus 1, there's just male and female here, so there's two groups, 2 minus 1 is 1. So at 1 degree of freedom, our critical value for chi-square is 3.84, which is far larger than 0.09. That means we fail to reject or we retain the null hypothesis, meaning that there really are not any big differences between males and females on the preference for those films. All right, that's going to do it. Thank you.